Hello, my name is Keshwani. That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani. We are here because we want to improve our math skill. Today is our lesson number 159 in the series of basic math. Today we'll do a problem on ratio and proportions. On the topic of ratio and proportions, our 19th lesson in the series of 20. The problem, as you can see, is already on the blackboard. Let's take a look, shall we? We are told that we have two people, A and B, working together. We are told that they can do a job in 15 days. We are further told that A by himself can do a fifth of a job in 5 days. He does fifth of the job in 5 days. The question simply is, how long will it take for B to do the job working all by himself? How long will B take to do the entire job working all by himself? Let's see what we can do here. It is a good time right now. It is a good time right now for you to pause the video, do the problem yourself, and once you have the answer, you can compare your work against the work that you and I are about to do in a few seconds time. I'll give you 5 seconds for you to be able to pause and unpause the video. I'll get out of your way. Alright, we are told that A can do a fifth of a job in 5 days. So this is A we are talking about. This is A we're dealing with. He can do a fifth of the job in 5 days. We're also told that together they take 15 days. Together they take 15 days. Well, if he can do 15 in 5 days, that implies that A should be able to do 3/5 of the job in 3 times the amount of days. If in 5 days he can do 1/5, then if you give him 3 times the amount of days, he should be able to do 3 times the amount of work. Instead of 1/5, he can do 3/5. That's how long it takes them. 15 days is how long it takes them to finish the job working together. But we just found out that in that amount of time, in 15 days, A actually does 3/5. If A does 3/5 and they finish the job in 15 days, then that in turn implies, this in turn implies that B must do 2/5 of the job in 15 days. He does 2/5 of the job in 15 days. Well, if he does 2/5 of the job in 15 days, that in turn implies that B must do 1/5 of the job, half the amount of job, instead of 2/5 to 1/5 is half. So B must do 1/5 of the job in 7.5 days. 7.5 days is half of 15. Instead of 15 days, if you give him half the time, in half the amount of time, he will do half the work. Instead of 2/5, he will do 1/5. You're almost there. He does 1/5 in 7.5. Therefore, that in turn implies that B can do the entire job, which is 5/5. Entire job will be 5/5. If he can do 1/5 in 7.5 days, he can do 5/5 of the job in 5 times 7.5. One more time. If he can do one fifth in seven and a half, he should be able to do 5/5, which is the entire job, in five times the amount of time. 5 times 7.5. You're almost there. 5 times 7 is 35, and then 5 times 2.5. Five times five is five halves. 5 times half is 5/2. 5 halves is 2.5. So it's 35 plus 5/2, 35 plus 2.5, which is same as 37.5. The answer is, it will take B 37.5 days working all by himself to do the job. Want to do one more? Yes? Let's do one more then. I'll give you a second to... Let's do one more. Again, as soon as I put it on the blackboard, I want you to pause the video and do it yourself, okay? The next one actually is pretty straightforward. That's almost this one, but still. Here we go. We are told that ratio of A to B is 3 to 5. We are also told that the ratio of C to B is 7 to 10. The question simply is, what's the ratio of A to C. What's the ratio of A to C? I will give you 5 seconds now. I will give you 5 seconds now for you to be able to pause the video and unpause and unpause the video. Do it yourself first, okay? And then compare your work against the work that you and I will do together in a few seconds time, as we always do. All right. We are told that A to B is 3/5. A to B is 3/5. We are also told that C to B is 7/10. C to B is 7/10. What we should understand and what we should realize is that we're looking for A to C. Right here, there is what it is. A to C, right? It's right there. Somehow we have to get rid of the B. Somehow we have to get rid of the B. And the way we do that is, we take A over B, which is what we know. Now, if you were to multiply the two ratios, we cannot get rid of the B. So we shouldn't multiply it. We have to divide the two ratios. Divide the two ratios. And now it will become A over B times, we take the reciprocal of it, becomes B over C. B cancels out and we end up with A over C. That's it, we are done. A over B, we are told, is 3/5. So it's 3/5 times B over C. Make sure you pay attention, it's B over C, not C over B. This is C over B, 7 over 10, 7 to 10. So B to C would be 10 to 7. B to C would be 10 to 7. We see 5 at the bottom, we see 10 at the top. Divide top and bottom by 5. 5 goes away and 10 becomes 2. And we end up with 3 times 2, which is 6 over 7. 6 over 7. That's it. This was one method. As you can see, I left half the blackboard empty. It was by design. It was on purpose. Now I'm going to show you a different method. So this is one method. This is more of a traditional method, more of a classical method, more of an academic method. But so is the next one, but it's a little bit faster. Here's what you do. We know we're looking for ratio. They're asking for the ratio of A to C. Instead of worrying about the ratio of A to C, what we ask ourselves is, why don't we figure out all the ratios together, A to B to C? Let's do it. A to B to C in one shot. A to B to C. Watch what happens. This work is right here, so you can compare this work with this work right next to each other. A to B, we already know, is 3 to 5th. It's given to us. A to B is 3 to 5th. So that part is given to us. It's 3 to 5th. We're done. We also know that C to B is 7 to 10. C to B is 7 to 10, which means B is 10, which means B is 10 when C is 7. You see? C to B, right here, C to B is 7 to 10. C to B is 7 to 10. But we have a 10 here and we have a 5 here. We have a problem. That cannot be 5. They all have to be the same numbers. Well, what do we do? Well, you take your 5 and multiply it by 2. So it becomes 10. And if you're going to multiply that 5 by 10, we have to go over there and the 3 becomes 6. That's it, we are done. It is essentially 6. The ratios are 6 to 10 to 7. And now we can figure out whichever ratio they ask. It doesn't matter what they ask, we can figure out all the ratios. They're looking for A to C. A to C is right here. A to C, 6 to 7, which is exactly what we found. I'll see you tomorrow, okay? Bye now.